Hello dear student, in the last period we have studied about the three characteristics of particles of matter. Actually we should write here three characteristics of matter. We can say not of is needed. Yes, these three characteristics are: matter is made up of particles and particles of matter have space between them. Second, particles of matter are continuously moving. Third, particles of matter attracts each other. Now we'll study about this attraction a little bit more. Please look into the activity number 1.6 given in the textbook and read it. So this is what I suggest you to do it. You can see here this activity number 1.6 we have. I have this activity number 1.6. You should read this activity from your textbook and then you should watch this video after it. See, remember this picture even, which is given here as a figure 1.3, and then we'll discuss it in detail. So let us move forward. In group 1, so they have given an activity and they have asked us to form three groups. In the textbook, we are given picture for this group. This particular picture represents group 1. You can see this picture. This figure 1.3 represents actually group 1. So, this is the group 1 that we want to see. In the textbook, we are given the picture for this group. Group 1 should hold each other from the back and lock arms like Idu Mishmi dancers. This Idu Mishmi dancers are the people who lock themselves with the help of their hands. And this is how we can understand about this dance form, and it helps us to understand even the force of attraction or the physical state. Group 1 has maximum force if we consider each human being or a student as a particle. So, if we consider it as a particle, then among this group 1, group 2 and group 3, this is the most stable or having the most attraction kind of group. This group probably represent the solid state. This group 1 is the most difficult to break. We cannot break this group very easily. Then we have the group number 2. The second group should hold hands to form a human chain. They just need to hold hands like the way we shake hands. So, you know, when we shake hands, how do we put our hands shaked, or how do we hold the hands? This is how they have to hold, and they'll just have to make the chain. And the third group, group number 3, the third group should form a chain by touching each other's fingertip only. You just need to put your fingertips to each other this way, and just you need to touch this way. But if you have, you know, group 2, then you will shake your hands this way. You just need to do the handshake. And this is how you can really explain the group by shaking the hands. Just you shake the hands. Now we'll understand in detail about this. That, you know, group 2 has a force of attraction more than group 3. But less than group 1, so it's a mediocre kind of force of attraction. If we consider each student as a particle, then group 2 probably represents the liquid state. To break group 2 is easier as compared to group 3. Group 1. So as compared to group 1, we can easily break it, but as compared to group 3. But it is tougher to break group 2 as compared to group 3. Here it should be 3. So as compared to group 3, we cannot, like we can easily break group 3, then group 2, and group 1 is the most difficult group. Now we'll look at group 3. Group 3 has the lowest or minimum force of attraction, so group 3 is easiest or was easiest to be broken or easiest to break. If we consider each student as a particle of matter, then group 3 probably represent the gaseous state. In the textbook itself, we have another activity which is known as the activity number 1.7. We can read the activity number 1.7 if we want to read it. Here it is. This is your activity number 1.7. So this is how you can read it. It is already given in your textbook itself. Now we'll discuss about this activity in detail. So activity 1.7, among iron nail, a piece of chalk and a rubber band, if we try to break them by hammering or by cutting or by stretching, chalk breaks easily from the and iron nail with the most difficulty. So we can easily break the chalk, but we cannot easily break the iron nail so easily. It is very difficult to break into the small pieces. So we can say that particles of iron nail are held together with the greater force. So among these three, we will find that iron nail has the greatest force of attraction. Then it comes to the rubber band, because when we stretch it or when we hammer it, it is not broken. But the chalk pieces can be easily broken by just hammering, or we can easily break it by stretching or by cutting it. So this is how we can understand this activity. I hope, my dear students, you are enjoying. Happy learning.